started out by brainstorming a few words we'd use to describe the city. Constantly moving, ever-changing, loud, diverse, smelly. Now, we found that the main problem of our section was, how do we portray all these aspects and so many more of New York City in one project that fits inside the Sepulveda display case? This is the main constraint that we faced this semester. How do we create a physical experience that all New Yorkers can relate to? How do we use art, architecture, and engineering to make something that we all can be a part of? We started out by breaking into 8 different groups. Each group focused on a specific aspect of New York City. Overall, we define New York as chaotic, living, infinite, entertaining, scenic, Cooper Union, and home. But what connects all these aspects of the city? What connects us all to one another? That was the concept that my group was interested in. We found that transportation is what connects New York and its people. We did this by creating constantly moving turnstiles that place marbles onto tracks. The marbles represent people moving through turnstiles and onto the subway to go throughout the city. Once the marbles reach the bottom of the sculpture, some will enter a music box where they will hit xylophone keys and make their own unique sound. Other marbles will be fed to other groups connecting the project. Next slide, please. These were some of our inspirations that led us to this design. Over here is a subway station in Stockholm where each step corresponds to its own piano note. The Wintergatan marble machine inspired us to use marbles to make music. These are some of the prototypes that we built throughout the semester. Over here is our original prototype, where the marble would hit a staircase made out of xylophone keys. Now, once we prototyped with an actually moving turnstile using a stepper motor, we found that the timing constraints of the stepper motor would make it too difficult to make a song. Thus, we concluded that it'd be better to have a music box at the end. Since the midterm, we focused on the lift. After the consideration of a number of lifts, we decided to go with a magnetic chain lift. We went to a local bicycle store close to 14th Street that generously gave us old bike chains and sprockets. Now, lastly, the last aspect of our project is this telephone that my partner found in one of the electrical engineering labs here at Cooper. Onlookers will be able to pick up the phone outside the display case and leave a message about their own experiences in New York. The next person to pick up the phone will be able to hear that message and leave a message of their own. In essence, transportation is at the heart of New York City. Next, James will talk to you more about the heart of New York.
As Delphine was saying, transportation is essential to New York as it involves the movement of all elements in the city. The city of New York is a dynamic itself, constantly moving upon its balance of curves and edges. Sharp man-made structures harmonize with the dynamic flow and movement of people in the city. Also, the city, with all its diverse and animatic aspects, is a living organism itself. We thought the heart of New York is the people and the city itself, providing all kinds of special experiences in our lives. We tried to capture this in our project, mostly with the mechanisms, colors, and shapes. The structure is divided into two parts, the pipes and the vessels, at the heart of a combination of rooms and arteries that connect and carry them. Alright, so the pictures on the left are our final scale. The final design was inspired by ideas that originated in our first two prototypes. The first two prototypes that you can see on the right are mechanical representations of bridges, which have led to us to think about how to deliver the message and what is truly important for us being part of New York City and the Cooper Union in a more intuitive and visual sense. The result is a complex kinetic structure that includes all disciplines of Cooper, including art, engineering, and action. By building this structure and presenting it to the community, we would like to share our experience that Professor Dylan Romanticus has offered along with our personal experience that we went through in the city of Rome. So the type structure for the sharp triangular structures, they represent the edges of the city. The straight lines from man-made structures suggest streets and buildings. Two marble elevators, which will be placed within the pipes, will visualize the energetic dynamic of the city. The fluid will show the dynamic movement, energy, and people of the city. The vessel structure, the round tubes, where fluid flows, symbolizes the smooth curves and lives of the city. Each vessel takes the fluid in and out of pipe structures as if the people enter and exit the city. Each vessel should illustrate each and every unique experience that the city takes. Another representative site of the city dynamic works within the shadows. The city's shape and shade changes by day and night, creating a striking contrast between the never-sleeping city and dark nature of life. The initial idea was to have lights alternate in brightness and position. However, due to limited knowledge and time constraints, we decided to have just a couple of lights constantly on. In retrospect, it makes more sense in the representation of the city since the city does have. Alright, to wrap things up, I want to reemphasize that our project focused on both dynamic and static aspects that is involved in city life. And naturally, as people travel to the city, there is bound to be an element of chaos. Our next speaker, Eric, will detail it.
Alright, thank you, James, for introducing me. Alright, so I just want to ask you guys, how many of you have been frustrated thanks to the storm that's caused you to be late for class? All right, so if you over there, how did you feel?
It's frustrating.
Okay. Well, we wanted to capture the hardship that every living being, the heart and purpose has in the face of chaotic one. So, our initial design went through a lot of processes, and we decided to meet up with artists and professors, particularly Professor Michael Young, who spurred our original direction from an audio setup with an LED matrix to more dynamic setup where components would interact with each other. And overall, we developed this idea of the cradle of chaos inspired by the BMW scuffed sculpture that's displayed here. Our cradle of chaos is meant to portray the artificial and natural chaos that is New York. All right, so our initial designs and prototype for an LED matrix, which is seen at the bottom of our cradle of chaos. You see it from an aerial view, as if looking from atop of the sky, looking down at the fragile artificial chaos that is Manhattan. And all of the LED lights in Manhattan randomize, representing the momentum of people moving around in our city. We have developed our LED matrix further by upscaling it and setting up a laser cut AutoCAD for our map of New York. We've had some issues upscaling our project, particularly with the limited control of the Arduino, and we hope for the next generation of students to improve upon our design for our LED matrix. Our pulley system is meant to represent the brain system that is present in New York City. The pulley system delivers the cradle of chaos up and down in our sculpture. Additionally, the pulley is located in the top of our sculpture, which actually supports the illusion of Staten Island. Our pulley system was developed with 3D printed gears and laser cut gears. Right now, our setup is a bit daunting considering the amount of motors we have to use. We redesigned a bit and decided to use just one driver gear for our setup. And we also saw some issues with our servo motor, which had limited radii. So we adjusted the ratios between the driver gear and the dripping gear to improve our design. One last component that you guys did not see in our last midterm is actually the humidifier detector. This one, we replaced our oscillation reaction from before simply because it was too unstable to have chemicals in our sculpture. So instead,